Oh yeah, get down, y'all. Hi everyone.
Hello.
It's video 3, and it's that week where we struggle for content. You know, when you start to make a video, and the video is about, you know, it's a vlog. It's like, yeah. You know, what do you do every week? You know, what's the stuff?
Yeah.
Like,
what do we do this week?
I actually don't do anything exciting.
Well, nothing new or anything yet.
No.
So.
No, it's like, well, I can talk about my carpool. I mean, there's not. Sometimes there's a week that's just, it's just a normal
it's
week.
It's just a regular old week.
Yeah. I mean, there was something a little different this week where she had her appointment.
On Wednesday, she had her 4-month checkup. So she went and she is 16 pounds. She's gained 4 pounds since the last checkup, which was at 2 months. And she's 26 and a half inches tall. Mm-hmm. So she's 95th percentile for weight and 97th percentile for height.
Mm-hmm.
So she's, and she has a jumbo head.
No surprises there.
No surprises there.
No, not for our kids at all. I mean, I don't know where they would get that from. Giant head.
Yeah. I mean, they compare the size of my head to your head. I mean, you have to have custom made hats. I'm just saying, you know.
So, I mean, yeah, she's a jumbo baby. We know that. We know where our children are and that kind of stuff.
But you're the smallest of them, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I am the runt.
How much smaller is she?
Let's see. Isabel, she's like a pound smaller than Isabel and like an inch shorter. Mm-hmm. She is like 2 pounds smaller than Demetrius. Because Demetrius was like, he was almost 18. I think he was 18 pounds. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then like a half inch shorter. So she's just barely shorter than.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
But she's growing great. So that's the most important thing. So.
Yeah. She's a talker, too.
Mm-hmm.
She likes to sing us the song of her people.
She likes to scream, and then she also has been really working on her hands. So.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. She's totally figured it out for, like, being able to pick stuff up and put it in her mouth.
Yep.
And every once in a while, it's like, you know, she'll get your hand, and she, like, goes like, she's like, cause, and he's like, bleh. Yeah. Why'd you put that in my mouth?
Yeah, she like forces it into her mouth, and then she's like, ew.
Yeah.
That was gross. Why did you let me do that?
Why did
That's
you
nasty.
Let me do that?
Huh.
So, but she rolls over.
Mm-hmm.
She can roll over now. She wants to sit up bad.
Yeah, but it's too hard for her. So she's like, she's in a sitting position, like struggling, like, trying to do it, but no. And her biggest entertainment this week has been her brother. Demetrius has been entertaining her with his dance moves and his karate moves, and she just laughs and laughs and laughs. She thinks it's so funny that he's doing it for her. So. Yeah.
Still won't laugh for me.
She doesn't do the belly laugh. She only does the belly laugh for Demetrius. Let's face it. I mean.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. I mean, she got shots too.
Yeah, she got like she didn't get very many actually. She got 2 shots and then. The rotavirus one, it's for, like, the stomach. It's a stomach virus. They drink it. It's like a little liquid thing. So she only got 2 shots and then that. But she was not happy. Not happy. She screamed and screamed and screamed. And then she screamed at the nurse.
Well, you know, she's, like, the best crier ever. Because she has, like, this really slow buildup.
Yeah.
And she sticks her bottom lip way out.
Yeah. It's very dramatic. It is. It's very dramatic. And that's what she did to the nurse. And he was like, I'm so sorry. We're not friends anymore. And she stuck her lip way out, like, holding on to me for dear life. Like, you're mean. I don't like you anymore. We were friends. Not anymore.
Well, she's leery of strangers anyway.
Yeah, she really is. And that's what the doctor was saying, that's, like, that's advanced. Like, apparently they don't get that way until, like, 8 to 9 months.
Mm-hmm.
So she's like, she really doesn't like strangers.
Mm-hmm.
So she's constantly like, as soon as someone looks at her wrong, she sticks her lip out.
She's like the dog. She's afraid of old people.
That's
people
true.
Who wear hats.
And old people, I guess it goes along with older people, but people in walkers or hats. She's like, nah. Well, the only difference is the dog particularly doesn't like men. She doesn't care about that. She just doesn't like anybody new. So she's like, no.
So nothing was really going on with the other two kids this week, though.
Well, they had testing all week for, like, their standardized tests. So that's pretty much what our week has been filled with, just them talking about taking the test and, you know, that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Except for on Friday. Like, and this has been, like, a theme, right? And it's not just with Demetrius' class. It's, like, with all the classes that they've been in since they've been here. Yeah. I understand this week is a little different.
Yeah,
because
they give them a reward, man,
they watch a lot of movies.
Yeah, Demetrius said he watched 3 movies on Friday. Well, what happened was they gave a reward to the different grades. They broke them up. You know, like, K through 3rd watched, I'm going to totally draw a blank on what they watched. Oh, Lion King. Mm-hmm. And then 4th through 6th grade watched Toy Story. It was as a reward for doing the AZ merit testing or whatever. Mm-hmm. But Dimitri said he watched 3 movies because what happens is every Fun Friday, if he meets his goal or if you turn in your homework or make sure that you finish all your work for the week, you get to watch. You could pick what you want to do in the afternoon. And he always picks the movie because he doesn't want to go outside and play. Or whatever. He's like, I don't want to go out and play in the playground. And it's like that, or you can do one other thing. I can't remember what the other thing is. It's 2 different movies and then play outside in the playground. He never picks the playground. Mm-hmm. He always picks the movie.
Yeah.
So he watched 3 movies, basically, on that day. Isabel doesn't watch too many movies unless, like, she is going on a field trip to a movie theater, but it's for, like, they're reading a book. So it's tied into
that. Yeah, so they're going to the Jungle Book.
Yeah. And so they're doing, like, Fractured Fairy Tales right now. They're studying that in their, like, language classes. So, I mean, that's part of that. But
so let's play a game. Let's play a game on why Melissa's going to see The Jungle Book.
Melissa?
Yeah, you. Why you're going to eventually see it.
I'm not going to see The Jungle Book.
Yeah. So let's multiple choice, people.
No, we're not going to. No, I'm not.
Because she's a fan of The Jungle Book. That's option 1. Option 2, she's a fan of Rudyard Kipling, the author of the Jungle Book.
So there's that answer.
Or option C, Idris Elba is doing a voice of Shere Khan.
I think.
Well, let's give a pause for people at home to play along.
And to actually look up who that is.
Okay, does everyone have their choice? Melissa, what is the reason why you would go see The Jungle Book?
Because Idris Elba plays a voice. I mean, it's not even him in the movie, it's a voice of him.
Mm-hmm.
But that's okay. I can handle listening to his voice as the bad guy.
Maybe our worlds will collide one time. And there'll be like this super spy the movie where it's Idris Elba, like James Bond, and Emily Blunt is in there.
Oh my God.
For me.
Yeah, I know. Well, you know he's going to be in Star Trek. He's the bad guy.
He's in the Star Trek we haven't seen.
No, yeah. No, it hasn't come out yet.
Oh, I thought he was in the last one.
No, they're still filming it.
Oh. Okay.
I'm pretty sure it might have come out and I just didn't know.
Yeah,
but
I don't know. I don't know, but we seem to work in all of Idris Elba's work somehow or another.
I have no comment on that. You've seen almost all of Emily Blunt's work, so.
That's not what we're talking about here.
I think the general,
I'm not on trial here.
I think the general idea is that we like English people.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true.
They're both from England. So.
I think that goes for the whole house, right?
Yeah,
because
Isabel super
Isabel watches, you know, YouTubers, and that almost all of them are from England, and then
Demetrius watches his YouTubers.
Favorite one, Dan TDM, is he's from
English.
England. Yeah. Yeah, there was like this really goofy picture of Dan TDM with Stampy long nose.
Yeah, like
parents, ask your children.
Yeah. Everyone's like, what are you talking about?
And like they're doing like a, I don't know if they're gaming together for someone's YouTube channel or for something for BBC Radio or
something.
Right,
because they're in the studio, yeah.
Yeah. So, and it's like, you know, two, you can see why they're popular, and then also like, I also understand why my son's into this.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, it was like a normal week for them. They, you know, doing the testing and karate on Monday and
just
all
normal
that kind
stuff.
You know, it's not a whole lot.
Yeah, not a lot going on. They're excited. They have several field trips. Demetrius has several field trips this month and then like field days this month and, you know, that kind of stuff. So Demetrius is really excited about that. Isabel's got a field trip, but she's working on a big project, so she's not necessarily too thrilled.
We're actually the ones that got some stuff going on this week. So you started us off on some newfangled, like, what is it, like a colon cleanse or something?
No, it's not. It's a green smoothie, you know, green smoothie.
I think I stand by my original statement.
Get out of here. You're so gross. I was going to say it's a colon cleanse. It's got me. It's a green smoothie. It's like a green smoothie challenge, like for a month. Now, we cheat and we don't do it on the weekends.
Yeah.
Because I didn't think I could get him to do it on the weekends. I drink a smoothie anyway for breakfast every morning.
Yeah.
Because I work out and then I just don't like to eat anything really heavy. Mm-hmm. So Dominic has been kicking it up in high gear diet-wise. So
yeah, because, you know, we fell off really hard on the diet and exercise.
Because I was pregnant.
Yeah,
so
yeah, with the pregnancy. And then once she was born, and obvious reasons for you. You know, and I kind of use it as an excuse that I didn't need to go.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So now that she's 4 months old, it's finally time where it's like we can really step back into it and go all in.
Exactly.
So, and actually the smoothie thing's been good. Like, the smoothies are good, and I have plenty of energy in the morning after drinking it. You know, it's not like
His lunch has been diet. He has not diet, but, you know, I don't know how to say that. I guess it's like low calorie.
Yeah, I mean, I like to complain about my lunch a lot. You know, this... I really got a problem with the person who wakes up early and makes me lunch every day. Like, I mean, I need some variation in my lunches.
Mister, I want to a schedule for my lunch, schedule for my breakfast. Yeah.
You trying to look at yourself in the camera? Is that what you're doing?
Or that she thinks that the microphone is a camera? She keeps looking at the microphone.
So, we started doing the green smoothie challenge, and it's good. Like, it's going good. Yeah, and I went back to running in the morning.
Yep.
So I get up so cheerily every morning at about 6:30.
By himself, too. It's amazing. Yeah. He just wakes me right up.
I just pop right out of bed, get my running clothes on. I always have my running clothes laid out for at night. That way when I wake up in the morning, they're waiting for me. And I just hop right out the door and go for a run.
Was that supposed to be something like, you want me to lay out your running clothes for you?
I mean, you already lay out my clothes for work.
I already lay out your work clothes. What else would you like me to do for you?
So, you know, and then I go run for I don't know, an epically long time. That's how long I go run. And I hate every step of it along the way.
I sleep while he does
Even
that.
The maintenance guys in the morning are laughing at me as I barely make it around the loop at the park. But I guess I actually have time to go do it. You have someone watching you while you... Well, sorry. You have an audience.
I have a complete audience between the baby, depending on when she decides she's going to take her nap or not. She usually sleeps pretty good, but sometimes not so well. And not when I want to do something where I'm like, okay, she's going to take a nap. I have it all planned out. Nope. And then if I just put her in her chair, or actually I did Pilates with her, and she was doing it with me on the floor. But the cat and the dog... The dog and the cats, they watch me too. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I have an audience to do it. But somehow I get it done, and then all the other stuff I need to get done.
Yeah. So, you know, we're back to exercising and...
Eating right. Well, not today, but...
Hey, as far as they know, they can't see the donuts back there. So, the pizza we had for lunch.
Well, you know. You work out during the week, that's what you get to do, I guess.
Yeah. So, hey, as far as everyone else knows in the world, that's what we're doing. We're every day. It's a lifestyle choice. That's what we do.
It is. Well, I mean, it is, and I do it every day, except for the weekends.
So, other than that, there's not a whole lot going on this week. How long are we doing? It's for a month we're doing that smoothie challenge?
It's for a month? Yeah, it's for a month, yeah. Yeah, for you, I'll probably keep doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, yours is the big deal is it's a green smoothie. That's what the big deal is.
Yeah. So other than that, not a whole lot going on this time. There you go.
Thank you.
You take her.
Thank you. Hi, Bobby.
So yeah, other than that, that's it this week. I know we're trying to do longer videos, but that's all we got going on this week. We got some other stuff coming up. We got some stuff.
Coming up next week.
I'm probably going to start trying to do a little bit better at making videos during the week and then adding them to this video during the week.
Yeah, so you have something to add to it.
Yeah. So we're going to keep working on it and keep making it a little bit longer and add some videos of stuff that we're doing out during the week. You know, there's a few things here and there. Maybe get someone to do a grocery haul.
I don't know who that someone would be.
Believe it or not, So if you want something to think about, you know, for a family of five, what is our food budget every 2 weeks?
Every 2 weeks for a family of five, including, like, toiletries, pet food, all that stuff, it's it's not actually $250 because I pulled the money out for gas. So,
yeah, so $190.
So it's $190, yes.
Yeah, so $190 every 2 weeks is feeds our entire family, mm-hmm. plus all the extras that we need in the house. So maybe someone can do some stuff on how she does that and how she keeps our budget so low on that kind of stuff.
Yep.
So everything we do in the house is super budget. And I do not complain about it whatsoever. I'm always like, it's what I want. Right?
Yeah. Yes. Actually, he comes up with some wacky ideas like, well, why do we need to do this? Can't we just use this instead of that? And I'm like, can't we just use old shirts to clean things? And I don't know whatever else. Can't you just make all your clean
things? Can't we just make everything out of cardboard?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. No, he only complains about not being able to buy things.
Yeah. I want tech things.
Yeah.
Tech things are expensive. So yeah. I'm left with, like, using all this stuff from, like, 2008. That way I can try and make things happen.
Sorry. Like a cardboard box that you drew a computer on.
That's what it feels like.
Beep, boop, 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 boop. I'm really doing some computing right now. Heavy duty.
Okay, well, that's going to wrap it up for this week.
Yep, I think that's it.
We'll see you next weekend.
Bye.
Bye.